disclaimer. GDI Lives, or John Roblox, is a popular Roblox YouTuber with an over million subscribers. And he is known for his overall outrageous behavior, which causes him to get a lot of hate. Most people, including myself, consider him to be a man-child because of his attitude toward his communities. My main motivation on making this video is because of a recent incident in the TDX server. He made an announcement about how he is nerfing something all because of quote-unquote someone's criticism about a game mode being too easy. He even mentioned who the person is, and now everyone is blaming them for making their TDX gameplay harder. I heard that they even got a death threat, but I cannot confirm that. But I do see that could be happening. He uses this person as a scapegoat. Now, instead of everyone complaining to John about this issue, it's this innocent person. Because of the constant harassment, they decided to leave the server. Update: I can't confirm if they ever did leave the server. The information I got said they did leave the server, but I'm unable to verify it when I check the TDX server. It looks like he either rejoined or he never left at all, so keep that in mind. It personally makes my blood boil with how he handled the cyberbullying situation. While there was an apology to the victim of all of this incident, the problem is that this apology was so ingenuine. Instead of admitting his mistake to the public directly and making it clear that he regrets what he is doing, he has someone else to say sorry on his behalf, which is his community manager. I strongly believe that if you were to make a mistake, you need to make the apology yourself. Do not have someone else who has nothing to do with the mistake you made to do it for you. What makes it even worse is that he posted this video on the server. It seems clear that John doesn't show any sense of remorse about what he did. The only thing he did was delete the post he made mentioning the victim. Also, about that apology that the TDX community manager made on behalf of John, when the community manager posted the apology, he called John stupid, but then he edited that part out. It really doesn't help at all that they even do that. Did John specifically ask them to cut that part out? If so, that only proves that he has a really fragile ego. So what happened to the victim now? I heard that as a compensation, he was given 50k gold for the backlash he has to face because of John's very bad decision. But it looks like it's too late. The damage has already been done. I hope that this incident will start getting John to stop acting childish, but I don't really know. It's been like this for a long time without any signs of changing. I feel really bad for the victim. They were just stating that power-ups are easy to farm in TDX because of Nightmare Mode in TDX XTB event. And then, John thinks it's a good idea to announce that he has nerfed Nightmare Mode rewards and then explain that the reason why it got nerfed is because of this person. All the childish behavior he did before did not get someone in trouble, it's just himself who has to take the blame for every action he does. Now, he got someone who isn't even responsible for the game development of TDX to become a victim of cyberbullying. How irresponsible. A former QA tester of TDX, which I will keep their identity private, told me that John acted similarly during game development, which is why some TDX QA testers hated working with him. So it's not just about the victim who got constant harassment because of what he said about the event, but it's also about his overall behavior as an owner of a quite popular TD game in Roblox. Clearly, you can't be carefree or something like this would happen. But John has been considered to be a very childish person despite being a fully grown adult for a long time. You could say that John behaved this way as a way to give rise to his identity for his YouTube channel, just like how iShowSpeed acts crazy as a way to make his video entertaining. But it really doesn't work that well for him, considering that he has gotten a lot of hate for how he acts. So he clearly isn't executing his ideas in the right way. All I hope for is that John finally changes his way and start being respectful instead of being the jerk he is right now. It's hard to figure out if he genuinely learned his mistake or not, considering he didn't even apologize directly and had someone else to do it for him. I'm basically jeopardizing myself by making this video. I could be banned from the TDX server because John is being petty and is unwilling to admit his mistake. Maybe not though. As said in the community manager post, they are willing to be transparent. So I'll see if they're being true to their words after this video gets released. I hope that John starts being reasonable after I make this video. We don't need any more of his manchild behavior. I want to see him start improving how he acts towards his QA tester, and I want to see him start improving on how he acts towards his audience. But of course, it's only a matter of time. It is up to him if he would like to listen to some YouTuber with a small audience compared to his gigantic audience. I had enough of how he has to make everything so ambiguous whenever he announces something. John always been like this ever since he made Reason to Die content. Now he has a really big audience and he still keeps up with his dislikable attitude. But it's a Roblox channel, so his audience will be full of children who are unaware that his behavior is not to be imitated. John didn't really think this through when he made that post. He is really carefree with whatever he announces in his channel or in the TDX server. And it is this time he screw up really badly. I could care less if he were to not make that one mistake. So now that concludes this video. Hopefully this video is a wake-up call for him to start changing and no longer be childish. I wanted to make this video to show that actions have consequences, and that if you make a mistake, there's no excuse to not make up for it. And you shouldn't get someone else to fix your mess. Be a responsible person and do it yourself. Before I end this video, I should clarify that this is about John himself, not about his game. It doesn't mean you should stop playing TDX, but you should not accept John's childish behavior. And as stated before, this video has no intention of harassing anyone involved in TDX development or staff team. So please do not raid the TDX server. It is immature and it also breaks the Discord's terms of service. If you were to get caught and got banned, then I hold no responsibility. Thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe with the notification turned on if you find this video informative. Also, I have a Discord server if you're willing to join. And I do communicate in Discord a lot. Hopefully, this is the only exposed video I ever gonna make. And I will see you all in the next video.